let's have discussion on the exact differential equation, how to solve. We will have discussion what is exactly a exact differential equation, how to solve the equations of exact differential equation, and also we will see some good examples in PYQs based on the exact. Okay, so let's start it, guys. So when we talk about the exact equation, let's talk about what exactly it is. So any differential equation is of the form, you can say here, any differential equation is of the form mdx plus ndy, mdx plus ndy is equals to 0 is called the exact differential equation, right? Any differential equation is of the form mdx plus ndy is equals to 0 is called the exact differential equation if, okay, is called the exact differential equation, the exact differential equation if del m by del y, we have here two things, m and y, right? M and n. So del m by del y is always equals to del n by del x, right? So this is the exactly the condition of exactness to checking the equation whether it is exact or not. First of all, the equation should be in the form of mdx plus ndy, dear students. Now second thing, the equation, if the equation is in the form of mdx plus ndy, then you have to check whether the value of del m by del y, means we have to partially differentiate this m with respect to y and partially differentiate this n with respect to x. So del m by del y is equals to del n by del x, then you will say this is the exact differential equation, right? So when it is exact differential equation, we can go for the solution of exact differential equation. Now how we will find out solution, let me show you one more time. So the equation should be in this form. So any equation is said to be exact if it satisfies this condition, means del m by del y is equals to del n by del x. If these two conditions are satisfied, then only you can approach for the general solution. And the solution for the, you can say the general solution is in the form of mdx plus ndy. But when you are talking about n, this n does not contain any single term of x, dear students. When you are talking about mdx plus ndy, so this n will not contain any single term of x, right? So you can say the terms of n not containing x into dy is equals to c. When we are talking about mdx here also, when we consider m, so here also we have to integrate only and only with respect to x. So here y will work as a constant, okay? So in general you can say any differential equation is said to be exact if mdx plus ndy is equals to 0 is there. This is the step number 1. Step number 2 is you have to check whether that is exact or not. So if del m by del y and del n by del x is there, then that will be exact. If that will be exact, then we have to approach with the help of general solution. So mdx plus ndy is equals to c. Mdx plus ndy is equals to c will be the general solution, dear students. Yes, exactly. If this will be the general solution, then what we have to do, we have to consider and we have to remember one thing, that m is containing as a, y is containing as a constant only, and n is containing, n does not contain any term of x, does not have any term of x, right? Does not have any term of x. Okay guys, right? So these are the three steps which you have to follow for the exact differential equation. Now let's approach to the question how we can go for this one. So we have some examples already here, and let me see. The first example is that x square plus y square dx plus 2xy dy is equals to 0, right? So let's approach to the example, dear students. We have first example as it is x square plus y square into dx plus 2xy dy is equals to 0. Okay, yes, so we can go for this one. So we have to check first of all whether it is exact or not, because in the examination there will definitely not mention, for as I already told you earlier, so in examination exactly there will be not at all in any question mentioned that whether you have to approach the question with the help of linear or you have approach with the non-linear, homogeneous, non-homogeneous, variable separation, right, or exact. You have to identify by yourself only, guys. Okay, so let's have discussion. X square plus y square dx plus 2xy dy. So when we will approach, we can see this is the form which we can compare with mdx plus ndy is equals to 0, where m is equals to x square plus y square, yes, and where your n is equals to 2xy. You have to partially differentiate m with respect to y. When you differentiate partially it with respect to y, it will give you 2y only. When you partially differentiate this n with respect to x, it will give you 2y only. Hence you can say that del m by del y is equals to del n by del x. These two things are equal, hence the equation is exact. Hence it is exact differential equation, guys. Yes, okay. So when it is exact differential equation, it's clear. When it is exact differential equation, we have to find the solution also. Yes, exactly. So when we will go for the solution, so the general solution will be mdx plus ndy is equals to c only. Okay, now let's approach to the general solution. When we will go for the general solution, my dear students, when we will go for the general solution, it will become what? M is what? X square plus y square. So you can write down x square plus y square dx plus n is what? 2xy. Now just remember my thing, as I already told you, whenever we will approach the general solution, here it's clearly mentioned that whenever we will write down n, that n does not contain, that n does not contain any single term of y, of x, right? So either in the n there is a form of x or y together, x and y means the multiplication of x and y, then you will consider it as zero only, right? And when if has the form x plus y, then you can go for this one, that because x is not possible, you can make it zero, you can go for y. I will show you in the question. So here in the first question we are having n is equals to 2xy, so we cannot take it because at the place of x you have to put zero only, right? So that's why it will be 0 into dy is equals to c, guys. Yes, exactly, 0 into dy is equals to c. So when you will approach, it will become x cube by 3. As we know very well, here y is as a constant, so it will be xy square only. Yes, it is equals to c. So x cube by 3 plus xy square, x cube by 3 plus xy square is equals to c, guys. Yes, exactly, we can approach x cube by 3 plus xy square is equals to c. So this will be your final answer, dear students. Is it clear? So you can easily approach this one. It's as this is a very very simple thing to approach. So x cube by 3 plus xy square is equals to c will be your final answer. Okay guys, right? So this is the first example. Let's talk about the second one. What we have in the second one, let's approach here only, right? We have a space here also. So the second one is 2xy dx plus x square y square dy. Now let's approach it, whether we can go for this one or not. So again, when you will compare, it is clearly seen that it is again mdx plus ndy is equals to 0 form. When it is mdx plus ndy is equals to 0 form, dear students, we can go for what? We can go for checking whether it is exact or not. Del m by del y should be equals to del n by del x. When you will write down your m is equals to 2xy this time, and you will find out the derivative of m, partial derivative of m with respect to y. So it will be 2x only, okay. So when you will approach, n is equals to x square plus y square. When you will go for this one, it will be del n by del x only, guys. Okay, del n by del x, so it will be del n by del x. Hence, we have to differentiate n, okay. And this is x square plus y square with respect to x only, so it will be 2x only, guys, again. So we can see, hence my differential equation, hence my given differential equation is of the exact differential equation form. So we can proceed according to the solution. So when we go for the solution, the general solution will become, dear students, as we know very well, mdx plus ndy is equals to c will be your general solution. Yes, exactly. So we have to approach m is equals to 2xy. M is equals to 2xy dx, yes, okay, plus n is equals to what? N is equals to x square plus y square. Now just remember one thing right now, I just write down here x, but we will not consider x because we know very well whenever we will find the solution with m dx plus n dy, we know very well here in the m, y will work as a constant, and here in the n we cannot contain or we cannot take any single term of x, right? So that's why x is not possible here. Okay, so when x is not possible, it means I have to write down here at the place of x 0. So when it will be in the form of addition or subtraction, you can write down, right? Because when you will write down 0, 0 plus something or 0 minus something is always something, right? So you can approach for that. But whenever it will be in the multiplication form, it will, the complete n will become 0. Just like in the previous question, here we have n is equals to 2xy. Here we had n is equals to 2xy. So when we approach x as a 0, so your complete n will become 0. So that's why when we were finding the solution, we approach n is equals to 0, guys. Is it clear? Okay, but now here we can see that n is equals to x square plus y square. It means here we can approach with the 0 plus something, right? So it will be y square only. So let's integrate this one. It will be 2y plus integrate this one. It will be y cube by 3 is equals to c only. So this will be your general solution this time, students. Is it clear? So it's a very, very simple thing to approach. I don't think you will feel any difficulty here in approaching the exact or the or finding the general solution for the exact differential equation. Okay, now let's approach to the next one. Okay, let's approach to the next one. So do we have any question other? Yes, we have. So x square minus ay dx plus y square minus ax dy. Let's approach here only, guys. So let me write down here only the question. So we can write down here only, it is, the third one is x square minus ay, yes, into dx plus y square minus ax into dy is equals to 0, yes. So can we go for it? Yeah, definitely we can go for it, guys. So when we, where the question, yeah, it is. So when we go for it, we can write down m is equals to x square minus ay, n is equals to y square minus ax. As we know very well, we have to write down here the partial differentiation of m with respect to y, partial differentiation of n with respect to x. When we approach it, it will be minus a only, guys, yes. When we approach it, it will be again minus a only, guys, yes. So we have to check only one thing, that whether the given differential equation is exact or not. So you can see easily here that it is a exact differential equation, guys, right? So when it is exact, we know very well how to find the solution. So let's approach for the solution. So general solution, hence it is exact, guys. Okay, so let's approach to the general solution. It will be m means x square minus ay dx, okay, plus y square minus ax dy. Now again you are getting my point. What we have to do exactly, whenever we have n in the form of x, we know very well at that x we have to put 0. So when we put 0, the complete n will not become 0 here. So it will be y square minus 0. So hence it will be y square into dy, my dear students. So when we approach it, it will be x cube by 3 minus axy, because here y is as a constant, and when we approach it one, it will be y cube by 3 is equals to c. You can leave here it, you can leave it here only, y, because we don't have any options. So when we have option, we can make changes according to the option. Whenever we don't have any option, we can leave it here only, right? So this will be your final answer, this will be your general solution, my dear students. Done. Okay. Now let's talk about this one again. This is a good question to approach. Let's approach it, guys. So we have 1 plus e to the power x. We have 1 plus e to the power x by y. Yes, exactly. It is into dx plus. Okay, similar question we approached in the homogeneous also. This is a question of homogeneous and same question, same to same exactly question we approached in the homogeneous differential equation also. Okay, let me see the next thing. Plus e to the power x by y, 1 minus x by y. E to the power x by y, 1 minus x by y into dy is equals to 0. Now let's approach it, guys. Let's approach it as we know very well. Okay, first of all, you have to check here whether it is exact or not, because we are not sure about the equation that it is exact or not. Okay, so that's why first of all you have to check for the given equation whether that is exact or not. If that is exact, then only you can go for the solution. Okay, so here m is equals to 1 plus e to the power x by y. Okay, and here n is equals to e to the power x by y. And you can write down 1 minus x by y. Okay, yes. So what we have to do, we have to check whether the first my given differential equation is exact or not. So if it is exact, what I have to check? I have to check del m by del y and del n by del x both. Yes, exactly. So let's talk about del m by del y. When you partially differentiate it with respect to y, it will be, my dear students, what? 0. It will be e to the power x by y. Yes, exactly. As we know very well, the differentiation of e to the power x is e to the power ax, or is e to the power x is e to the power x only. But here we have to differentiate with respect to y. So here we have to differentiate again x by y only. So when we differentiate x by y again, it will be minus x by y square. Okay, right? So this is called the differentiation of differentiation, means the chain rule, right? Okay. Let's talk about the del n by del x. When we approach here, we have exactly two options, right? Means we can go for UV method, right? First and second. So when we approach it, it will be e to the power x by y into 1 by y only, because the differentiation of x is 1 only, right? Now it will be as a constant 1 minus xy. When we approach e to the power xy will as a constant, it will be 0 minus x. Differentiation of x is nothing but 1 only, right? So it will be minus 1 by y, guys. Okay, so let's write down it together. It will be e to the power x by y by y minus x into e to the power x by y minus e to the power x by y. You can see here we can cancel out two terms. These two terms will be cancel out, guys. Yes, exactly. Okay, yes. Okay, let's have discussion. It is y into y. It will be y square. Yes, okay. So we can see what we will have. So this was your del m by del y, and what we will have as a del n by del x, we will have minus x by y square into e to the power x by y, which is exactly similar to the del m by del y only, right? So hence now we can say that this differential equation is exact, my dear students. So when it is exact, what we have to do? As we know very well, when it is exact, what we have to do? We have to proceed for the general solution, right? Okay, let's approach to the general solution. Let me write down here general solution for you. So the general solution will become mdx plus ndy, guys. Yes, it is equals to c. So at the place of m, you can write down 1 plus e to the power x by y into dx plus at the place of n. Now here you can see in each and every term it's containing x. So that's why at the place of n, when you will write down x as a 0, the complete n will become 0. Okay, so that's why it will be 0 into dy is equals to c. So when we integrate this with respect to x, it will be x plus e to the power x by y we already have. So as we know very well, the integration of e to the power x by y is e to the power x by divided by 1 by y only. Yes, exactly. So we know very well the integration of e to the power ax is e to the power ax by a only, right? That's why. So that's why you can write down. Okay, write down. Okay, so it will be C only, it is equals to C only, guys. So when we approach it more and more, we can write down x plus y into e to the power x by y is equals to C only, right? So this will be the final answer, guys. So I think you can easily identify how we can approach the exact differential equation, how we can go for the exact, okay? Let me write down one or two more examples for you. So let's have approach here. I have few more questions for you so that you can have enough practice of exact also, right? So let me write down the question. Yes, so it is e to the power y, find the solution. The question is always written as in the form of find the general solution or the find the solution of the given equation of the given differential equation, right? So we have differential equation as e to the power y plus 1 into cos of x, yes, cos of x dx plus e to the power y into sine of x dy is equals to 0, right? So let's approach it, guys. Let's approach it. So when we will approach here, we can write down m is equals to e to the power y plus 1 into cos x, okay? And your n is equals to e to the power y into sin x. How we can say, because we know very well this is nothing but m, okay, it should be dx, okay? Now, as we know very well, the question is in the form of m dx, this is dx, plus n dy, right? So that's why it will be n and it will be m only. So we have to partially differentiate m with respect to y. When we partially differentiate m with respect to y, it will be partially differentiate with respect to y, to e to the power y will be e to the power y. So the cos x will be here only, right? Because the cos x is exactly nothing but the cos x is exactly nothing but the constant only. So it will be e to the power y cos x, and the differentiation of 1 will be 0. Then the differentiation of n with respect to x, it will be e to the power y as a constant. The differentiation of sin x is cos x only, right? So we can go for this one only. So we are having exactly the same values. You can see, dear students, here we are having the same values. So we can say del n by del x is equal to del m by del y. Hence it's exact, my dear students. Yes, okay. So when it is exact, we have to approach. Okay, when it is exact, we have to approach with the help of general solution. So let's find what will be the general solution for that particular differential equation. Yes, so the general solution will be, my dear students, m dx plus n dy is equals to c. Yes, m is equals to e to the power y plus 1 into cos x. But when we approach to the n, here we are having sine 0. So it will be 0 only. So the complete n will become shunya, will become 0 again, my dear students. So it will be 0 dy is equals to c. So I think you are feeling more comfortable because we are doing exactly the same thing. If you practice for the one question of exact, it will be same. If you go for the 10 question, it will be same because the process will be same. Okay, so the things are exactly same. I am just showing you the varieties. So e to the power y plus 1. So it will be e to the power y. Okay, we have to integrate with respect to x. Then it will be 0 dy is equals to c. So when we integrate it with respect to x, with respect to x and y both. So with respect to x, it will be x e to the power y. Yes. And when we can write down even it is as e to the power y cos x plus cos x dx. It will be 0 only, so it will be c. So we can write down like this so that we can approach easily. Okay. Yes, so we can approach easily. So when we go for this one, we know very well it will be e to the power y. The integration of cos x will be sin x plus the integration of cos x will be sin x only is equals to c. More and more you can take common e to the power y plus 1. So even you can take as it is because it's a constant term. So the integration of cos x will be sin x only is equals to c, my dear students. So it will be your final answer.